I often look at other parents, especially when they're complaining, and I'm sort of like, wow, it would be really nice to be normal. But at the same time, I wouldn't change who Ryan is either. It was December 24th of 2011. So Ryan was 5 months old, and I was bringing him down the steps after his feeding, and I felt him go completely stiff in my arms. And when I looked down, he was blue. At the time, I didn't think seizure. I just called 911. At first, they thought it might be reflux or just a one-time seizure. They let us go the next day, and we just really hoped that it was a one-time thing and that it would never happen again, and we went on with life for the next 2 weeks, and everything was normal. And then it happened again. We went to the hospital, and they decided to keep him, and sure enough, the next day it happened again, and they all saw it. The scariest part for me was not just watching Ryan have the seizure, but then also thinking, what could all of these seizures do to him? And he was having one after another after another. So it wasn't just thinking about what's happening in the moment, but the long-term effects of this disorder.
It happens at any moment. We've had experiences where we were going upstairs and he's had seizures right at the top of the stairs. Luckily enough, we were right behind him to catch him. So every step you take, everything he does, you have to be a helicoptering parent. You have to just be always around. We went through a period of time of 2.5 years without seeing a seizure. So you start following that belief, like, okay, everything's, again, it's gonna be okay. This, you know, he's gonna be a normal, he's gonna be a normal kid. He's gonna go out and have a normal life. My understanding right now, there's less than 450 people worldwide with the same genetic mutation that Ryan has. So it's extremely rare. I mean, they vary from kids that are very, very disabled to kids like Ryan that are functioning, able to live almost a normal life at this point. Once we got the genetic testing, we were able to find out the medications that worked for him. It's the great thing about CHOP. They're doing all the research, giving you all the opportunities to find answers, and you know, we're able to use them to help try those different opportunities to make that happen. The storm is over, it's a new morning, it's something beautiful, oh so wonderful. I can feel it now, sun comes through the clouds, it's a brand new day. Having that diagnosis has been extremely life-saving for Ryan. I don't know that he would be where he is today without that testing. It gives children like Ryan a chance. I think it came around at just the right time for him.